Hello everyone. In today's session, we are dealing with vocabulary. As we know, vocabulary is an integral part of all MBA entrance examination. So, vocabulary becomes an integral part of preparations also when you are giving such entrance exams. Now, the domain of vocabulary is so vast, the content is so rich that in order to master it or even to know a certain amount of words will require a lot of time. So, you need strategies to learn new words at a faster pace. So one such strategy is the one which I picked up for today's session. We learn words through root, prefix and suffix. Now remember, these are the three components of a word. So once we know at least some roots, some prefixes and some common suffixes, we are sure that some words are there about which we can be certain of. Now let's look at what is the definition of a root. The root is the main part of a word to which prefixes and suffixes are added. Now what is happening? It is the main part of a word, and to that word certain suffixes or prefixes are added to modify or to add another meaning to it, and then a new word can be created. So we are now with one root or with one prefix or with another suffix, we can alter and know a family of words associated with that root word. Now let's look at the example of root words. So I've picked up three examples. Let's see the first one. Dog or dogs. Now dog or dog means, dogs means opinion. So words that come out from these root word or the tree, the family tree with dog at the center or dogs at the center will naturally have something to do with opinion. Now the words that I have picked up is dogma or dogmatic. Now let's make a sentence with dogma. Now what is dogma? A set of established belief. So in today's world, some of the traditional dogmas are no longer relevant. Now that means a set of established belief which was relevant in the past is no longer relevant today. Let's come to dogmatic. Dogmatic noun is an adjective. Now it implies a person who holds certain dogma very closely to his heart. And let's have a sentence with dogmatic. The dogmatic preacher was adamant in his views. So this is a sentence which says that he has certain dogmas associated and he believes in them and he is very adamant with all his beliefs. Let's look at the second root word, cert. C-E-R-T, cert means sure. And sure, with sure and cert, you might have a certain amount of words, a number of words that you already know. So let's look at the words. It can be certain, so I am certain that you know some words with the meaning sure. Certify, any document which needs to certification, or suppose there is a document and I want to certify it, means I want to verify its truth. Let's come to the third root word. Now this is a word which is man. Now this man is not the masculine gender. The root word man means hand. So look at the words that we have picked up, manual or manuscript. Now manual is any labor which is done with your hands. For instance, sewing and stitching is a manual labor, you can say. Now manu here is hand and script here is written form, the writing part. So any handwritten script is manuscript. Let's have an example sentence with manuscript. So the novelist finished his first manuscript within a week. That means he had handwritten the script within a week. After root, the central part, let's go to the affix which comes at the beginning. Now that is called the prefix. Now a prefix is an affix that is attached at the beginning of a root word to alter or create new words. To alter or add to its meaning and create new words. Let's look at the examples. Re is the first example. Now re means back or again. So re is something which when it comes to you in any word means that you need to go back or you need to come again to it. Let's look at the words replace, recall, rewind. Can you give me or think of any sentences with all this? Now recall is not recalling someone who is gone, but then remembering in mind also. So remembering things is also recalling. Replace, you place something which is out of place. And then rewind is connected to tape and films, wherein you rewind a tape and go back to the beginning. So we will always refer to something which is going back or again. Super, the second prefix that we have picked up is super. Super means above or over. So above or over in rank, in hierarchy, or maybe even in objects which are more that you require. So super or above has the words. The words that I have picked up is superior, a person of higher authority. Supervise is someone who is observing and directing an act or executing of a task. Superfluous is more than necessary. So the same thing, we come back to the root over. So if you have more than necessary, it is superfluous. Let's come to the third prefix, it is circum. Circum means around or on all sides. Immediately, you go back to your geometry classes where you have learned about circumference. Now circumference is the line, the boundary that encloses the center in a circle. So something that goes around means it reflects the root circum. It has to have the root circum. Circumstance. Now circumstance is a situation that you are having all around you. Fine. Let's come to the third part, and it is the suffix. Now suffix is the affix that is attached to the end of a root for the same reason, either to modify it or to change the meaning. Add to the meaning or to add or to create another word. Now the first suffix that we have picked up is able or evil. The meaning is capable of. Think of words. Incredible, remarkable. So incredible is unbelievable. Think of sentences with it. Remarkable is outstanding. So all that words which have I-B-L-E or A-B-L-E behind them will always mean that they are capable of the things that the first part of the word is denoting. Now come to the second suffix, an or ian, un or ian. Now the meaning is one who is. Let's look at the word, politician, musician. Now these are people who are what the words denote. So for instance, politician is a person who practices politics, musician, a person who practices music. Let's come to the third suffix, and it is ive. Ive again, the meaning is performing an action. Now let's look at the words that we have picked up. Comparative, offensive, defensive. So any person or anything which is comparative is performing the action of comparison. Fine. So these are a few tricks, a few strategies that we can apply. We kind of think, and any word that we come across which is unfamiliar to us, try breaking the parts, try thinking about the root, try thinking what is the prefix, try thinking what is the suffix of the words, and then try to relate it. Try to relate it so that you remember it later on by just thinking about the prefix, the root, or the suffix. So these three are tools which will help you to relate to unfamiliar words. They lead you to words which you are uncertain about. I hope this session helps you in knowing and dissecting the words better. Thank you.